सहनावतु सहनोभुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति 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 ॐ योगेन चित्तस्य पदेन वाचां मलं शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोत्तं प्रवरं मुनीनां पदञ्जलिं पदञ्जलिं प्राञ्जलिरानतोऽस्मि ॐ शान्ति 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 श्री सद्गुरु महाराज की जय। वी हैव सीन अप टू 28 सो दिस डिस्कशन इज ऑन द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ ए रियलाइज्ड yogi. His mind is inclined towards liberation, the final emancipation. And then he is in full practice of the sadhana. It means whatever he practiced previously, that practice is giving the result now. So the 27th sutra said, even in this stage, there can be obstructions. So after reaching to this stage also, there can be obstructions. So the sadhaka should be very careful. The reason is the previous habits, we say as samskaras, they have the power to produce new motions, new desires. They are in functioning, so that is not destroyed. So the samskaras, the habits can produce the desires connected to I-ness and so. The samskaras in dormant form, they are not seen because of new samskaras, new actions. But those are there. And when they will be destroyed? The answer came in 28th sutra. They will be destroyed when the ultimate emancipation comes. Hanamesham kleshavaduktam. It has been already told that these samskaras are destroyed like the kleshas. Kleshas are destroyed in two ways. One is that pradiprasavaheyaha sukshmaha. After ultimate realization, the subtle form of the kleshas, the sufferings are destroyed. And by sadhana, by practicing meditation sadhana, you can remove their functions, you can control their functions. Because sadhana is also a function in the mind, it's a modification of mind. So when you are inclined towards one modification, the other modifications are suppressed, so they are not working. So this way, till you reach the ultimate goal, the sadhana should be there. If you stop the sadhana, there is the chance for the old samskara to rise. So don't give gap. That is what the discussion is. Now, taking it further, the next sutra is stating the Dharma Megha Samadhi, the most important part of this Yoga Sutra, we can say, because this Dharma Megha Samadhi is a direct cause of emancipation. This is named as Samadhi, but it is not Samadhi. In Asambrajnata Samadhi, there are no thoughts. Thought process is stopped there. But in Dharma Megha Samadhi, the thought is there. The subtlest thought, that is discriminative knowledge, that is there. So now the sutra says, प्रसंख्यानेप्यकुसीतस्य सर्वथा विवेगख्यातेः धर्ममेघः समाधिः प्रसंख्यानेपि अकुसीतस्य सर्वथा विवेग ख्याते है धर्म मेघ समाधि. प्रसंख्यान, हियर इज द हाइएस्ट नॉलेज ऑफ मेडिटेशन, दैट वी से ओमनी सेंस, द हाइएस्ट नॉलेज ही गेन्ड दैट बिफोर कमिंग टू दिस लेवल. So that is, we have seen in sutra, the last chapter, 13 number sutra. So sarva bhava adishthadrittvam sarvajnyattvam cha. So this is the highest knowledge that he is gaining. He knows everything by his mind. So the highest knowledge of meditation gives this result. But this yogi is not taking that as highest. He is renouncing even that knowledge, the omniscience. He is renouncing it. Why? The reason is, there sarvajnyatva means the sarva, everything also there. Everything. So the yogi knows everything. So the knowledge is there and the object is also there. And this is, it is special. It is sarvajnyatva, you know everything. It's very special. But even in that, there is a relation of prakriti and consciousness. It is there. That is why this prasangyana means that by repetition of meditation, he gained that. So that repetition of meditation is called prasangyana. He is repeating the knowledge. So that is why it is based on practice and connected to the object. Although it is omniscience, but it is not the ultimate state. So he renounces that. So prasankhyanepi akusidasya. So even the akusida means he is renouncing even that highest. It is thinking that it is not highest. So prasankhyanepi akusidasya. Why it happens? Because he is based on renunciation, that what we say param vairagya. He wants only emancipation, nothing else. No production, no manifestation of prakriti he wants. He is thinking beyond that. So his goal is emancipation, nothing other than that. So even this sarvajnyatva is secondary for him. It is not very important. So prasankhyanebhi akusidhasya. That is why, because his practice and renunciation is continuing. Akusidaha, that is why he could renounce that. Then sarvatha vivega khyade. In that state, in all condition, the vivega khyadi, the ultimate discriminative knowledge, can stay. Because if you go after the omniscience, then this cannot stay there. There the objects are there, and the reflection is also there. You are knowing everything because you are completely connected with your chitta. The discrimination is not there in that knowledge. Although it says, Satva Purusha Yor Atyanta Sangirna Yoho Pratyaya Vishesho Bhogaha. There it says. But that is not ultimate. That is within the siddhis. It's one of the siddhis. That is helping for this stage, previous to this stage, but that is not the ultimate. So therefore, prasangyanepi akusvitasya. E prasangyana means all general type of cognitions are collected here. Whatever you say as knowledge is not ultimate. It's again the manifestation of intellect. So get rid of that. Then sarvatha, then this can happen. Sarvatha, in all conditions, in every way. Viveka khyatehe, that viveka khyati remains. The discriminative knowledge that remains. Then that stage is called dharma meghaha samadhi. In this stage, if we compare with the experience in Vedanta, then in this stage it is similar. Only the difference is, Vedanta says only you remain as Brahman, aham Brahmasmi. That is the experiential knowledge. Here, the discrimination is there. I am separated from Prakriti. This discrimination is there. But knowledge, both the places are the same. There is also knowledge. The mind is there. Mind is working there. Then knowledge is there. Here is also the mind, the samadhi prajna is working there. There the practice is brahmakara vritti. Here the practice is discrimination only. The separation. You must know the character of Prakriti, the essential nature of Purusha, then you know what is it. So this continues. So here we have to remember that the Asamprajnada Samadhi is not the ultimate of yoga, yoga philosophy. In Sankhya also it is same. They also say about this knowledge. And after that, when you get this knowledge, you can experience the Kaivalya, otherwise no. So just before Kaivalya, this Viveka Khyati is there. So this Viveka Khyati is named as Dharma Megha. Dharma Megha means cloud, cloud of all the virtues. All the virtues are achieved here. So this stage is full of virtues. So that is highest virtue is this, to attain this stage. So cloud of the virtues, that is this samadhi. So cloud of virtue, this just named it, that's all. Because in a poetic way, just named it as Dharma Megha. In some commentaries, they are trying to find some meaning out of it. But we see it is generally named as Dharma Megha Samadhi. It seems that this name was there before Patanjali. So he took the same name. Like in 26th Sutra, again he is putting that the Tada Viveka Nimnam Kaivalya Pragbharam. That is also poetic language. So this is the Dharma Megha Samadhi. On this stage, there is no longer a danger of falling. But just before there was danger. In this stage, once you attained this, now there is no danger of falling. Now you cannot go back. In Vedanta also they say, once you have the satchatkara, aparoksha jnana, that is forever. Before that, anytime, you can fall. You will be confused. There falling means confusion. Again, this superimposition. So after this stage, it is ultimate. Now you are guaranteed to attain the liberation. So there is no slipping, there is no sliding, no falling, nothing. It is completely safe. So Dharma Megha Samadhi. Now, then after Dharma Megha, what is the result? So now one by one is what is a rewinding it, going back to the source. Tata klesha karma nivrittihi. The result of Dharma Megha is Tataha Klesha Karma Nivrittihi. Thereafter ensues the cessation of Klesha. Nivritti means cessation, destruction of Kleshas and Karmas. Kleshas we know afflictions or the afflictions. In the second chapter it came, five types of afflictions are there. Avidya, Asmita, Raga, Dvesha, Abhinivesha. These are making the problem. The all cause of problems is this five. So these are called kleshas, sufferings. The cause of sufferings. So they are removed and then karma. We are talking about karma, this most confusing and so very detailed we discussed about karma in whatever way it is possible. And we are answering the questions also, how it is possible. Now this karma confusion also is cancelled here. Now after this there is no confusion about karma. So the klesha karma nivrittihi, this is the ultimate. Now before concluding karma, we have one more paper left regarding karma. So you have this paper, classifications of deposited karmas. So just we see that also, because now it is going to end. Now we cannot discuss about karma. So here the last point. It is Sutra 4.8. It is related to that sutra. Reference Vyasa Bhashya 2.13.1.3. You have this paper, something like this. Now you got so many papers, so you are confused. To find out paper. Yes. No, it is single paper. Yes. The classification of karma, it is connected to the sutra where we discussed the cause of karma, prarabdha, and how prarabdha is formed, and which are the karmas are destroyed by knowledge, and which are the karmas are fructifying karmas. There are so many varieties. So you will get more idea about this. Sometimes is more idea is more confusing. But this will give some clarification. So how this prarabdha is formed? Out of the bundle of karmas, the deposited karmas. So deposited karmas are there in samskaras. You see, deposit of habitual potencies. We have still this. This is connected to this. So all the deposits are there in unmanifested form, unseen form, unconscious state. Then out of that, the vasanas, then smriti, then iccha and indriyas, everything comes out. Okay? Okay, you now look at the paper. Drishta Janma Vedaniya. This is Sanskrit name. Experienced in this birth. So these certain karmas, they are experienced in this birth. And after that, two diversions are there. One is definitely fruitive and indefinitely fruitive. Niyata, aniyata. So we perform some karmas. Every day we are performing. Among those karmas, some karmas are definitely fruitive. They are giving the result in this birth. And some karmas indefinitely fruitive. We don't know when it is going to give the result. Now you are performing pujas and some sadhanas and like that. You are helping somebody with compassion. So these karmas is not directly giving the result here. It is indefinitely fruitive. We don't know when it is going to give. But you will get the result. Okay. And similarly, Adrishta Janma Vedaniyas, experienced in unseen other lives. Such karmas are there. Those cannot be experienced in this birth, because the chance is not there. You did some karma for another experience. You want to fly in the sky with the wings, not in the aeroplane. So this karma you did, you are decided become a bird, something like that. Now that is not possible with this body. That karma will give the result when you change this body. That is registered in your mind. You remember that. That is there. So it will give the result in this next body. You have to change the body. And similarly, you have done some karmas for heaven, knowing from the scriptures, or somebody told you, if you do this, you go to heaven. So you did that karma, and you have to wait for heaven. Okay, so those karmas are called Adrishta Janma Vedaniya. Actually, these karmas are most confusing, because we have no trace how it is, what it is. So, in that also, there is two definitely fruitive and indefinitely fruitive. Both the places are the same. So, out of this, Adrishta Janma Vedaniya Niyada Vipaka. Now, the classification, first classification. So, the Adrishta Janma Vedaniya Niyada Vipaka. This is definitely fruitive karmas experienced in unseen lives. You have to take all the words there. Definitely fruitive karmas experienced in unseen lives. Now it is definite, but it will give the result next birth only, next time. What it creates? It creates three effects. That is birth, lifespan, experiences. Experiences in the sense, the objects for experiences. So this we have learned in Sati Mule Tad Vipako Jatyayur Bhogaha, in that sutra. Actually this is connected to that sutra also. Now we got this body. What we got, this body, now we are not completely liking it. Okay, anyway we got it. We have to experience it, no other way. So, we take it, we are keeping it. But if you ask somebody, you completely like your body? He says, no, this body has this problem, it is not it is not beautiful, and sometimes back pain, sometimes headache, and sometimes stomach pain, and all these problems are there. If I could get a better body. So this is there. Everybody is, all are like that. So it means this body is, giving this body, before giving this body, whoever gave this body, they never consulted us. This without asking us, they gave the body. Or there was no meeting that we are going to give this body, you are ready to take, or there was no selection. Then there was no chance of selection. It means it was unseen. It was prepared in some other level and give to us, and after, once we are here, we are aware about that, we are aware about all these problems. Now, this is one important thing with our birth and the previous connection and after connection. So now, being this in this body, you are thinking about a better body, you are planning for that, for better birth. It means you want to take another body also. If you ask somebody, they say, if we could change this body, we are ready to change. They are trying their best to change the body. Plastic surgery and all other surgeries, and they are changing all the parts of the body. They are doing it. It means they are very, very much liking for that. So that itself shows you have next birth. Because if you so much like this body and you want better than this something, so this is registered in your mind. This is again deposit as habitual impressions. So they are the source, and they will calculate everything. When your desire is completed and it has full strength, then next body is ready. It is going to be manifested. So these karmas are called Adrishta Janma Vedaniya Niyata Karma. So if you want a beautiful body, so meditate on that. Do all the karmas for that, full concentration on that. Definitely you will get next birth a healthy, better body. There is no doubt. These karmas are called definite karma. And then Drishta Janma Vedaniya Aniyata Vipaka. It means indefinitely fruitive karmas experienced in this birth. Indefinitely fruitive, why we say it is with less strength. That is why it is indefinite. We don't know when it is going to give the result. And some karmas, you may not be caring for that. When you perform it, after that immediately you get the result. There are karmas. And in Shastra also says, Tribhir Varshai, Tribhir Masai, Tribhir Pakshai, Tribhir Dinaihi, Atyutkadaihi, Punya Papaihi, Ihaiva, Phalamashnuti. See, if you have done a strong karma with a strong motive, then you will get the result within 3 days, within 3 weeks, and 3 months, and 3 years, according to the strength of the sankalpa, the desire. So the experience, we all have this experience. If you are helped some, without any condition, if you open-mindedly, if you help somebody or do something in that level, you will get the result immediately. This time I had a very good experience that because last year I was flying from Cochin to Delhi. I was going for the program there. So Cochin to Bangalore and Bangalore to Delhi. It was the connection plane. So I entered and it was there. When the Bangalore, we were changing the flight. Two old couples, they were just in front of me. And they were trying to take out their suitcase from the cabin, that is, above cabin. So they were heavy body and it was the old age. And so seeing their difficulty, I just helped them to take it out, and I brought the suitcase with me because I was having only one small suitcase. So I helped them up to the, out there. So we have no conversation. Just I brought it, that's all. They were following me, they were happy. And then they just gave. And we never asked, who are you, from where are you? No, nothing. Just I gave, and then I went for my next flight. So I went to Delhi, then there was program, actually it was some program there. Then the next time when I was returning back to Cochin, the same incident happened to me. So there in front of me there was something like 60 years old, a couple. So when I took my bag, I was, and the friend, I kept my bag, I was working. And the person, he just hauled the bag, my bag, and he took it. In the way I did for the other person, the same way we have no conversation, no Om Namah Shivaya, nothing. Just pulled my bag and brought it down and kept it there. And then a smile, he went away. And so I was wondering, why? Because he is older than me. There was no need to take my bag. Why he took? Because just this is the karma. Then I remembered, you see, without a condition you did that. So the same is coming back. Within days. It was like 2-3 days gap maybe. It happens like that. So there are many experiences in this level. When you do something like this with all hearted, without a condition, it will reflect. Because somebody is seeing that. And they have no connection. That we can make some logic that seeing the old person's difficulty, I helped, that was my role there. And here when you see, they might have thought this is a Swami, seeing me like a Swami. Okay, it's a Swami, they are respecting Swamis or something like that. So they did it. So we can put some logic there, but there is some connection. Otherwise it is not possible. So these are the karmas. It is directly giving the result in that level. This is called Drishta Janma Vedaniya Anyatakar Vipagas. So these karmas can be the cause of experiences or lifespan or both. These karmas cannot give birth. It cannot give birth. Only new experiences. And it can give little life span more if you do such karmas, but not the cause of birth. It cannot give the birth. Adrishta janma vedaniya aniyata karmas. Adrishta means unseen. The indefinitely fruitive karmas experienced in unseen births. This has threefold operations. This type of karmas have threefold operations. So first is destruction of unfruitive karmas. So those karmas are not enough strong to give any result. It is so small, so little. So destruction of unfruitive karma, that is one case. Another case, after this discriminative knowledge, after this realization, the karmas are destroyed. The sanchita karma, what we say. The accumulated karmas. So they are destroyed. So in this way, this adrishta janma vedaniya karmas are destroyed. Indefinitely fruitive karmas. Because definitely fruitive karmas give birth. You cannot stop that. That becomes prarabdha. This definitely fruitive means they are ready to give the result as prarabdha. It's already fruitive. It is started giving the effect. So the second operation is merging into the principal fruitive karma. Now it is something interesting. So one karma, that is the strongest one, is ready to give the result, the fruit. Along with that karma, there is some similarity, means some relation is there. So the connected karmas, those karmas also join with this main karma, the strongest karma. Now, they may be giving different effects, but the strong karma is giving a birth. With that, this other karmas also come. That is why in a single birth one can experience good things, enjoyment, then suddenly it changes into pain and sufferings. This we can see in all world there, it is there. So how it changes suddenly? What is the reason? His mind changes. It means the strongest karma, they give the result first, and the light karmas with less strength, they give the result later, but they are there with. It is adrishta, so we cannot know what is there. It cannot be seen, but they are there. So we should be careful, or we should accept these changes. It's also with same karma. Can suddenly change the life. Either way, positively or negatively, good or bad. So this is the because of these karmas merging into the principal fruitive karma. There are other karmas. This is the second operation. The third operation is inactively staying back for a long time because it is being overpowered by the fruitive principal karmas. There are karmas accumulated in the samskaras. Now, certain karmas, they are not getting the chance to give their fruits. The reason is, if they can give the result, it means the similar fruitifying karma is ready to give the effect. Along with that, those karma can work. Now one karma is there, the strong karma is for human birth. So along with this karma, which is giving the human birth, the other similar karmas which are related to this, and they are also ready to give fruit in this human birth, can come together and give result there. But now there are karmas which are not connected to human birth. They are connected to some other births, but they are not very strong to give their own result. They cannot make a body, so that much strength is not there. Now they are weakened. So then what will happen? So that is the situation there. It is a rare situation, but it is there. Inactively staying back. They stay back. They wait for the time to come. They stay back for a long time. For a long time, because it is being overpowered by the fruitive karmas. The other fruitive karmas are stronger. They are coming and they are giving the fruit. But this weak karmas, they are unable to do anything. So now they are accumulated there. You see, this all description when we see, like Vyasa is seeing everything, visualizing everything. There is a bundle of karmas and this part in this file that these are the karmas, and another file, the other karmas. As everything is classified such a way, it's beautiful. So this way, we can see even in heaven, we see stories in Puranas. Lord Indra, the lord of the gods, he is also having some problems in between. Although he is having strong karmas of good karmas, what we say virtues, with that he become God's leader. He is ruling the heaven. But even then he is also having some problem between. It means these karmas are there. They are disturbing it. And with that he is also having some pain. Sometimes the stories are there. So this is related to this. And in human birth also similar karmas you can see. And now the last form. Drishta janma vedaniya niyata vipaka. It is definitely fruitive in this birth. The second one was indefinitely fruitive. This is definitely fruitive. That is the only difference. It can be the cause of experience and span of life. only two, it can produce only two results. One is the experience, it is means good and bad, enjoyment and suffering. And it can reduce the span of life or increase the span of life. Little bit is possible with this. So this karma is connected to prarabdha only. But it is definite, is not definite, indefinitely fruitive. It is changeable. So when you do sadhana, these karmas, even with the prarabdha, if this type of karmas are there, then you can remove that. But the strongest one, definitely fruitive, you cannot change. So some shastras say, even you can change some part of prarabdha. That is this category karma, in this category. This is indefinitely fruitive, so you can change it, you can divert it. Otherwise it is not possible. So this is the story of karma. So we completed the story of karma now. So tadaha klesha karma nivrittihi. This way, the all the karmas, the indefinitely fruitive, indefinitely fruitive, unseen and seen. Now for this yogi, realized yogi, no karmas are effective. So he is beyond that. That is the effect here. Okay. Om Purnamatah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudasyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om.